Welcome back to Quest for the Couch, the series where we take a deeper look at local multiplayer games. Today we're looking at My Singing Monsters Playground, a spin-off game of an extremely popular mobile title. This is a Mario Party-inspired game that's out on PS4, Xbox One, Nintendo Switch, and PC. I'll be talking about the PC version today. When it comes to couch multiplayer gaming, Mario Party reigns supreme in just about every aspect you can think of when it comes to fun with friends and also screaming at your friends like children. There just isn't anything that comes close to this kind of subgenre of gaming, especially to Mario Party itself. Every now and then you'll just get something that barely flies on the radar, but it stays either very niche or it just doesn't hit the mark. My Singing Monsters Playground is yet another attempt at this subgenre. This is a game with a solid foundation of minigames, but unfortunately, that's all it has. There's no big board where everyone rolls dice and moves around on. It's just minigames, but they are themed in the style of Mario Party, and they are quite fun. You've got your solo and free play mode, but the main attraction is the tournament mode. As you play a new minigame, you unlock them in the free play mode to be played over and over again. After each minigame, one player is chosen to select one of three minigames that come up on the screen. Similar to Mario Party, you've got free-for-all style minigames, 1v3 and 2v2. No matter how many players you have, your group is filled up to 4 with bots, and you have 3 different difficulties to choose from. The bots are good, but maybe they're a bit too good. They seem to absolutely dominate on certain game modes, even at medium difficulty. And even on easy, they can be a challenge for younger players. My little cousin was saying that they cheat. I can honestly see that. Once you pick your minigame, you're given a little preview screen where you can actually practice it before you hit the start button. It's identical to the newer Mario Party games in that regard, which is a good thing. If a game is going to copy another, you might as well copy the better aspects. There are some competitive elements beyond just minigame to minigame. Tournament mode awards gems based on where you place, with 4th place in free-for-all or last place in 2v2 and 3v1 awarding no gems. Bonus gems are awarded at the end of the tournament, but the best they can do is swing an already close game. You'll get rewarded for stuff like most projectiles fired or something like that. It's kind of arbitrary. But aside from that, there's not much to the tournament mode, even though it is the highlight here. I think the selection of minigames is pretty solid. I've played about half of them and they're all pretty fun and easy to learn. Since this game is sort of aimed at all ages, I wanted to get the opinion of someone from the younger audience side. I got my 8-year-old cousin to play it with me, and he seemed to enjoy it to a degree, minus the cheating CPU. If we were to rate the game based on just the minigame aspect and not price or feature set, the game would actually score quite highly with me, and I'd easily recommend it to anyone looking for a quicker Mario Party minigame fix. It manages to copy a lot of its inspiration's better aspects. Unfortunately, the game doesn't copy all the important stuff from Mario Party, most notably the sheer wall of content that those games have to offer. And this is where the game falls apart. We'll talk about it in the wrap-up. Okay guys, for this series that we do, Quest for the Couch, I like to sum up the game based on 3 criteria and give you my final thoughts. So my criteria being price, pickup and play aspect, and lasting appeal. Let's get into it. So the price is the biggest killer here. It's $40, putting it in tier 3, which is anything over 30 bucks for me. When it comes to tier 3 pricing for a local multiplayer game, I at least expect an online multiplayer component when you're spending that much, and this game does not have that. I either expect an online multiplayer component or a damn good single player component, and this game has neither. And that might seem weird to complain about. Why would you care about a single player online component? Well, it's because when you drop $40 on something like this, you're getting a game that's going to be basically a paperweight if you don't have friends over. It's just going to be sitting in your library, not being played. And don't forget, if your friends are over, they actually have to want to play it too. So if they're not in the mood to play it, well, you're not playing it either. So for a game in the tier 3 price category, it leaves much to be desired for something that only has mini games, fun as they are. I do think you can get value out of it on a deep discount, as there are a decent number of mini games here, but they're still eclipsed by any Mario Party game, even on an emulator, so for pricing, it's not great. Now for the pick-up and play aspect, it's pretty good. You'll be starting up a tournament mode and getting into mini-games with your friends in less than a minute. You just select your characters, AI difficulty if you got it, walk over to your desired mode, and boom, you're off to the races. I had no issues getting my controllers working with the game. I use a DualShock 4, Switch Pro, and Xbox One controller all at once. and they all worked fine. Although the only little caveat is that you do have to pick your character one at a time before anyone else can join in, and that kind of threw me off. But otherwise, getting into a game is really quick and straightforward. The only issue is that you do have to play a minigame in tournament mode before it unlocks for the free play mode. So you will be playing for a bit before you unlock your favorite minigame. But I'm mostly fine with that for the sake of having some kind of progression system, as shallow as it is. You are also playing minigames to unlock minigames. You're not grinding lots of the same stuff over and over again, intentionally, or playing challenges for the single player only component or anything like that. Although this can lead to problems as only one person can select games at a time, and when you just want to unlock all the minigames, the group favorite game could be constantly selected over picking a brand new unlockable minigame. But it does not take that long to unlock everything. Now for the third criteria, lasting appeal. This is a rough one. No online, only 40 minigames, most of them are free-for-all, so you're lacking variety, no main board game mode, no enticing single-player mode. It's tough to recommend. I think if you want something really well polished that you can play with players of all skill level, this game works really well, but I'd only recommend it on a discount. If you're looking for a game to play with anyone that you can break out at any time, honestly, just emulate a Mario Party game and put in a cheat code to unlock all the minigames out of the box. If you're looking for a Mario Party type game on Steam and you've got a more adult or mature group, check out Pummel Party. I haven't played that one, but it's been out for a few years now, and it's got tons of content updates in that time, an online multiplayer mode, in addition to local, and it's less than half the price of My Singing Monsters Playground. It seems like this game was just sold to cash in on a popular mobile game brand license, rather than being made to be a complete and enticing product. I do recommend My Singing Monsters Playground, but only at a very steep discount, as I did enjoy my time with the game. As for free content updates like Pummel Party has been getting, I wouldn't hold your breath for this one. Alright guys, thank you very much for watching. I'll see you next time. Top 5 best and worst games of the year is gonna come out soon, hopefully. I'll see you next time. I'm out.